What's up, KidzRock kids? I hope you little chicken nuggets and tater tots are doing awesome today. And I'm so excited you're joining us for week two of the Grub Club, where we're talking about being good friends. So before we can do that, we need to stand up wherever we're at. Make sure we have some room and let's get ready to worship together. Are you ready?
Feeling breaking out like an echo. Your love is so
job worshiping, friends. Now we're gonna check in on our friends JC, Amelia, and Miss Marichek. Well, see, JC and Amelia are in lunch detention because they haven't been very good friends. But this week, they're gonna learn about having each other's backs. And then we're gonna jump into our Bible story where we're gonna learn the same thing. We're gonna see a story from the Bible about David and Jonathan. They were the bestest of friends. That's because they always told each other the truth and they had each other's backs. But also, the most important thing they did was keep God at the center of their friendship. So let's sit back, relax, and learn all about friendship.
You know, JC, I've been doing some thinking.
Oh, great.
Wow, rude. Okay, anyways, since we're gonna be in here for like 4 full weeks of Grub Club, you know, we should probably get to know each other.
Okay, what do you want to know about me?
You know, everything, like the most important things, like what's the baddest thing you've ever done, or who's your crush? You know, I heard that you had a crush on Josie from math class.
No. And even if I did have a crush on her, I would not tell you out of all people. You know, I heard that you gossip and that you spread rumors and talk about your best friends behind their back.
That is not even true. I've maybe done that once or twice, but I've totally got my friends' backs.
Yeah.
Like you would know, you don't even have any friends. I have tons of friends, and you don't even hang out with anyone.
No, that's by choice. You know, I don't really trust anyone. I used to have these friends and I told them secrets, but they turned around and stabbed me right in the back. Nobody else is good for me except me.
JC, Amelia, what's going on? Y'all need to calm down.
JC over here is telling lies about me and accusing me of being a gossip. He's just jealous because I have a ton more friends than he does. And I've maybe lied about my friends like once or twice, but they've totally forgiven me, I'm sure, because who would want to be my friend?
Is this true?
Well, I mean, everyone just goes and talks about you and spread rumors about you, so what's the point of having anyone?
Well, it seems like both of you need to learn to be less selfish.
Why do I need friends? I mean, if they're just gonna go back and hurt me.
True friends are gonna be there for you, good or bad. And they're there to make the fun times funner and the bad times better, you know? So whatever happens, it is hard to get close to people because there's always that chance that they can hurt you. But it's better to learn to trust people and let them in regardless, unless your heart will shrivel up like the Grinch's.
Oh, like the Grinch, my favorite Christmas movie. You know, the Grinch is my favorite character too.
Oh my gosh, me too. I can relate so much to the Grinch.
But see, the Grinch's heart was changed because one person believed in him and one person took him in and was willing to sacrifice everything just to love him. I think we should do the same.
Right, like Cindy Lou Who believed in the Grinch when everyone around her was making fun of her.
Yeah, sometimes it's hard and you can be shamed by other people because you take in someone that isn't like you or doesn't look like you or talk like you, but just taking a sacrifice on someone and letting them in is all worth it.
So when I have a friend that's doing something that they shouldn't be doing, should I make sure that they don't get caught or get in trouble? You know, is that having my friend's back?
No, not exactly. See, when you are a true friend to someone, you call them out on things that they don't see, or sometimes you have to spare your friends from hurting themselves. That could be from lying to their parents or doing something that you know they shouldn't do. Sometimes you have to call your friend out in a loving way and tell them, hey, like, that's not okay. A true friend has their back. And a true friend saves their friend from hurting themselves too.
I think I can do that. You know, sometimes I do get pretty lonely not having a friend. I think I just have to find the right person to be my friend.
Yes, and it can be tough finding true and good friends that have your back no matter what. But we're gonna learn more about that in the next video. We get to see two people who have each other's backs pretty much their whole lives. Maybe we can get a thing or two from it.
That's awesome.
Yeah, let's go.
Slapstick Theater. David and Jonathan. This is Jonathan.
Hey!
Who was the son of King Saul and a warrior in Israel's army. This is David.
Hey!
Who would later become the king of Israel.
Huh?
After David defeated a great giant, he was brought before King Saul and he met Jonathan. They immediately became friends.
Yeah!
and Jonathan made a pact with David and showed him that by giving David his robe and weapons.
Oh, hang on.
From that time on, David was successful in all he did. And King Saul became jealous of David and very angry. Saul wanted his servants and Jonathan to get rid of David, but because Jonathan loved his friend David, he warned David of what his father was planning.
Oh, no.
Jonathan went to his father, King Saul, and talked him out of harming David.
Okay.
For a time, David was safe from King Saul's plans.
Phew.
But not long after, the king's jealousy and anger came back, and he tried to kill David.
Whoa!
David got away, and his friend Jonathan came to help him.
I got it.
Jonathan tried again to talk his father out of hurting David.
No.
But now King Saul was convinced he needed David to be gone. Jonathan was angry and sad that his father would not let his friend go. And he knew that David would have to go into hiding and run from King Saul. Jonathan met David one last time, and the two cried and said their goodbyes. Jonathan told David to go in peace and that they had a special bond in God's name. Then David left and lived a life on the run from King Saul, and Jonathan returned to the town. Even though they were separated, the two were the best of friends and were an encouragement to one another.
Yeah!
David and Jonathan were such good friends. That's because they understood that sometimes you need a sacrifice for one another. And, well, sacrifice is our word of the week. Can you say it with me? Say sacrifice. Oh, that was pretty good. Now, sacrifice means to give up something we value or something we really like for someone else because it makes them feel better or helps them. And when we sacrifice for others, well, we show others how much we love them and how important they are for us. And sometimes we need to sacrifice a little bit to show others that God loves them too. Because even though sometimes it's hard to make those sacrifices and to give up those things that we love, well, if we only think about ourselves, we're not gonna have friends for very long. And maybe it would make it easier if we thought about, well, how God sacrifices for us. Well, God sent Jesus, his son, to make one of the biggest sacrifices for you and me. Jesus sacrificed his own life, even though he was perfect and did nothing wrong, well, to save us. And that's pretty amazing. So maybe the next time when we think about sacrificing our snack pack for our friends or giving up our tablet time for our parents, well, maybe it'll make it a little easier because we know that God sacrificed so much for us. So, let's keep that in our minds as we go throughout our days. And, well, we need to do our need to know. And our need to know this week will help us remember to have our friends and families back because we want to be a good friend and a good son or a good daughter. So ready? Stand up tall. Let's do our need to know together. You ready? Say, I will have my friends back. Let's try that one more time so it sticks. Ready? I will have my friends back. Great job, KidzRock friends. I can't wait to see you next week for week 3.